Hi everyone, this is Jason here from the Nathaniel School of Music, and in this lesson we are going to look at a simple 5-note exercise, ABCDEDCB, basically 5 notes, and all you're going to do with these 5 notes is play them up and down. And while playing them up and down, we are going to learn some of the other time signatures which you may encounter or which you're looking forward towards encountering. The time signatures which are not very common, what we usually call as odd time signatures, things like 7, 7 by 8, 5 by 8 and those sort of things which are not common time, or 4 by 4 as we popularly know it, right? So the exercise is basically A, B, C, D, E, D, C, B. Basically these notes are all part of the A minor scale, the first 5 notes if you will. And I think the minor scale sounds a lot nicer for some reason. So the first thing you want to do is to just play the exercise over 4-4. Even though this lesson is about understanding the odd timings, try to get the even one or the common one first. So try to play it in 4-4, counting 8th notes. So in order to count 8th notes, what you're going to do is play the exercise. First of all, on the piano, try to use all your fingers. The thumb, index, middle, ring and the pinky. And basically play 2 notes for every beat. That's when you're playing 8th note. So you go 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and... Try to avoid counting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So you don't feel the difference between the on beat and the sub beat. Right? So let me show it again and try to count. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and... Right? You could also play the pulse in your left hand, maybe with a single A or the root, like 2 and 3 and 4 and... If you're new to this exercise, just try to make sure that the weaker fingers of the piano, like the ring finger and the pinky, don't slip while you play. Like the ring finger is a bit weaker, right? So you don't want it to slip. And play something very random. So if you still need some time with the 4x4 version, which is... Try to also play it maybe a little faster. And try to get some nice control into yourself while you're playing the exercise. So you may want to pause the video now. Do the 4x4 version really well and then unpause it, and then I'm going to start talking about the odd time signatures like the 7s and the 5s and so on, right? So anyway, so let's now look at the odd timings, 7x8 and so on. So as you know, 7x8 has 7 beats to the bar, or 7 quavers, 7 eighth notes as we say. So when you count it, it feels a little odd, because it's not 1, 2, 3, 4. We don't move very normally. We move in a very odd way, because it's an odd number, I guess. So a good way I found to kind of understand this 7x8 is to take the same exercise with eight notes and make the same 8 notes somehow squeeze themselves into 7 beats. So a beat is nothing but a time container for sounds. So you can have 8 sounds in 7 beats, right? So the way you could look at it, visualize it, could be to make 1 beat contain 2 notes. So in the diagram as well, which you guys could download in the description, which we've also put out with notation, you'll find that beat number 6 is what I've divided into 2. So that'll be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. So beat number 6 gets divided into 2, and that allows you to squeeze in 8 notes into 7 beats. And that's exactly what's happening. So let me try and show that to you. 1, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1. You see what happened at 6, I hope, where the beat number 6 was as long as all the other beats. I was playing at a constant tempo. but it got two notes, and those two notes were not given to it randomly. The beat 6 got divided exactly into two, and you could squeeze in two notes into that. You could call those as 16th notes or semi-quavers, right? So let's see how that sounds again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 3, 4. If you see our old version, this is on even time. This is on the odd time. So you can use your left hand again. Theoretically, you could perhaps make any beats, any of the seven beats quicker, or the quicker is a wrong word. You can make any of the seven beats accommodate more than one note, as I said earlier. So in the description or in the picture which you're seeing, you will be dividing beat 6 into 2. However, you can divide other beats as well, and that's going to be the next part of this tutorial. So if I divide 6 again, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6 gets divided, right? 2, 3, 4, 5. Right? And if you just see my left hand while I'm playing this exercise, I'm trying to divide it between the root and the octave. So maybe the root A could be played at beat 1, and maybe the next octave A could be played at beat number 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Let's see how that sounds again. 3, 4, 5, 6. Right? You could also, I mean, the way I look at it is whenever you're trying to get more and more confident or more and more comfortable with one hand, in this case the right hand, you should try to move the left hand as well. It's not about only focusing and obsessing over this one hand. You don't really improve yourself, in my opinion. You need to have another challenge or another goal. And the piano is an incredible instrument that way. The other goal to distract your main goal will be the other hand, which is playing some awesome stuff as well, right? So in the left hand, perhaps you, as you're practicing the right hand, you could bring in the left hand to go A and the high A octave. Right? And you could also change these notes around. You could also play other stuff like maybe F or D, F in the left, D, G, E. And if you look at my right hand, the right hand is very, very, it's the same, isn't it? It's earlier we did na 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 A B C D E D C B. The same motion is basically repeated on 7 as well. But to make it 7, two notes just got faster. Ta na 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 na. Right? So let's look at a few other time signatures as well. And there's a download available, so you could download this with notation. And if you guys don't know notation, I think that's also fine. You could follow what I'm playing by ear, and you can always leave a comment if you have doubts. Okay, so now looking at 6. So the way I've done 6 here is, with 6, you have 6 beats to fill 8 notes. We are still trying to do 8 notes, right? So 6 beats to fill 8 notes. So what do we do? 2 beats have to hold 2 notes, right? It's just, you just have to do the math. So in this case, I'm keeping beat 2 and beat 5 to carry 2 notes. Let's see how that sounds. One, two, three, four, five, six. One, two, three, four, five, six. it. And again, as always, bring in your left hand for some fun. So the left hand's basically playing the A as well as the next A at the 4 of the bar. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now bringing in our right hand. Change it. Right? So try and move the left hand as well. So now what about something like 5? Right? We could actually do it on any kind of time signature, but I'm just choosing 4 by 4 and then lesser of that, because if we go more than 4 by 4, if we go to something like 9 by 8, then you perhaps have to add a note. So I'm trying to ignore that in the video, but you could practice that in your house by just adding one more beat. In this case, we are subtracting beats, right? So the last time signature I want to talk about before we then focus exclusively on one of the time signatures for the lesson is 5/8, 5/8, or 5 beats per bar. So if you're doing 5 beats per bar and now you have 8 notes, 3 out of those 5 beats have to store 2 notes each, right? So 2 threes are 6 and then 2 more are remaining. So what I have done for the demonstration is to have beat 1, beat 2 and beat 4 to divide. So that'll sound like 1 and 2 and 3, 4 and 5. 1 and 2 and 3, 4, 5. 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So if you see, beat 3 and beat 5 are not divided. 1 and 2 and 3. 4, 5. And you could keep the entire piece of music interesting by getting your left hand to create some grooves on 5. So a good way to just look at grooves is just divide that 5 into 2 parts and take maybe 3 of those hits, 3 of those hit points, and maybe play those hits in the left hand. 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2. Right? So far, the entire exercise has remained pretty much the same. It's ABCDEDCB. So let's just recap what we've done so far and then move on to the next lesson, or the next sub-lesson, if you will. We took ABCDEDCB, divided each beat by 2, playing 8th notes, 1 and 2 and 3 and 4, and practiced that. Then we tried some odd time signatures like 7... Well, 6 was not odd, but we did 6 as well. So the concept behind it is you have 8 notes and X amount of beats, which is less than 8, in this case 7. So if you're doing 7 beats, what you could do then is one beat, which is a time container, could have more than one sound, right? In this case 2, right? And so on and so forth. So now moving on to lesson number 2, wherein we are going to use subbeats, right, and play them only over 7/8. So the entire lesson number 2 is going to be on the 7/8 time signature. So again, if you want to revise what I've done, perhaps pause the video, try out all the different time signatures, especially 7/8, which is going to be the topic of our tutorial, and come back and hit play. Right, so moving on. So if you look at the sheet here, which I would recommend you guys to download, you will find I've written a lot of permutations on 7/8, right, using staff notation. And all I've done there is to take different beats of the 7, Basically, you could take beat number 8. Sorry, there are not 8 beats. There are only 7 beats. You could take the 7th beat and divide it into 2. Or you could take the 6th beat and divide that into 2. Or take the 5th beat, divide that into 2. So basically, you have 7 exercises because there are 7 beats. And each of the 7 beats could divide themselves into 2. Right? So I'm going to show you how to play this exercise from the back division till the front beat getting divided. So the back last beat will be 7. Let's see how it sounds, shall we? So you go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7, right? So 7 will have a faster set of notes. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Try to play it at different speeds. Right? And then I guess in the last part we again use 7, but we divided the beat 6 into 2. So that'll sound like how we did earlier. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6, right? So 6 got divided by 2. Then you could divide the 5th beat of the 7 by 2. That'll be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1. And just to keep things interesting, you could play either a root and its octave in some rhythm here, or you could even play things like chords. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Maybe A minor and F major. F major. D sus. And if you observe, I'm also finding it a little tricky because I guess my conscious brain is trying to figure out which chords to go to next. While I needed to have converted this right hand of mine into, I guess, the subconscious brain where you're not really thinking of it. So I guess practice makes perfect. You need to keep doing it over and over in the right hand. Keep your left hand simple and then bring it up. So now if you have to maybe divide beat number 4 out of the 7, it'll be ta na 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 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, right? And I'd advise you also from time to time, try to also perform the exercise without your main instrument, which is a piano in this case. So try to perform it with just your voice. Try to sing it, or maybe just use the left hand. Na 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 na. Right? Na 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 na. Then once you get a grip of the exercise, and I guess a grip will be try to sing it and then try to play it. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1. Right? And then what's left? We have to then divide beat number 3 of the 7. So that'll be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, tun, tun, ta, da, da. But if you observe, it's still 8 notes. So the exercise remains the same, doesn't it? A, B, C, D, E, D, C, B, A, B, C, D, E, D, C, B. Then you guys could perhaps divide the beat number 2, which will be tan, da, da, dun, da, 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 dun, da, 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 and so on. And I also think that this exercise also brings out the creative side in you along with the technical side. And I usually like to make my exercises like that. So you're not just looking at it as technique and getting to be a better pianist. You should try to also get to becoming a better musician. And what happens when you displace these subbeats? Like, practice them by dividing the beat 7, then divide the beat 6, then 5. Is your ear will feel completely different music, won't it? Like something like feels very different when as opposed to something like that, which is a completely different phrase, or I guess you could say a completely different melody. So maybe this melody will sit better in your composition as opposed to the other one. So it's good to have as many options as possible, and it will also motivate your left hand to do different things. With every different 7x8 permutation, as I've showed you, it'll allow your left hand to also be very, very creative. Or another way to look at the left hand is it's trying to survive more, first of all, right? It's trying to cope up with what's new in the right hand. So it will automatically do some different stuff with the right hand changing as well. Okay, and the last permutation, I guess, will be to divide the beat 1. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Try to also count it as you play. It's a little tricky, but I would advise that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 1, 1. You see, 1 gets divided. 6, 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 4, 5, 6, 7, right? With some chords. And then if you get good at all these rhythms, you could perhaps try and combine them. That's also a lot of fun. So maybe I have no idea what I was currently doing, but I guess a good way to start would be to take 2 rhythms. May not be all the 7, which I did now and completely got lost. So you may not want to do too many things, otherwise you lose track of what you're playing. And you should always be in track of what you're playing, because that'll help the technical side. The technical side will check, or will figure out whether you're playing it right or wrong in the first place. And the creative side is always thinking, oh, I want to make a song out of this, or I want this to become a melody. So you need to have both those things going on for you as you play, right? So what have we done in the second chapter, you could say, is we've taken the time signature 7, we've taken the same old exercise, ABCDEDCB, and to make 8 notes into 7, obviously one out of the 7 beats would need to have 2 notes. And in this chapter, we've looked at all the possible permutations, where beat 7 could be divided into 2, beat 6 could be divided into 2 and have 2 notes, then beat 5, beat 4, beat 3, beat 2 and beat 1. For some reason, we started with 7, then we moved all the way back to 1. But if you want, you can start from 1, dividing that or having 2 and then going all the way to 7. So the last part of this lesson, or the last chapter, will be again to keep the same 7 thing going. And you could look at this in maybe the third picture, which has been attached. And in this particular version of the exercise, you take the same 7 beats with 1 permutation. Perhaps you divide beat number 6. So that'll sound like, which you've practiced earlier, right? 3, 4, 5, 6, 6, 6 got divided into 2, right? 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 The only task for this less exercise is don't start with A at beat 1 all the time, but follow the same linear order or going up and coming down. So what's the note after A? Well, B. So you need to keep your same finger shape where B is still played by the index and start the rhythmic phrase from B. So you go. So B, C, D, E, D, C, B, A, B, C, D, E, D, C, B, A. So you see C and B get a bit more hurried, or that'll be played faster. Why did that happen? Because we started on B. So right, and this is clearly creating a completely new melody or a completely different phrase. However, you still have to keep the drill up and down, right? This may confuse you a bit, so I would first of all suggest you to play it slowly until you start digesting the melody. You need to understand it as a tune. So na 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 na, you should be able to sing that back, not just play the drill mechanically. Okay, so we've done it on A, now we've done it on B. And now you can start on C. As mentioned earlier, I'm trying to keep the same finger which you used to have for that respective note. So C will be played with the middle finger and you're going to start the phrase with that finger. C, D, E, D, C, B. The entire feeling changes of the melody. It's like a completely new melody, and all obviously the chords will also change because you're stressing on different notes there, right? Moving on. So now where do we start? A, B, C, D. We start with our ring finger. This will be a nice workout. So D, E, D, C, B. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 3, 4. So there we started with our ring. Then on the way up, the last note is the E. So you don't really have any more up notes to play, right? So you'll have to just start down and then up. Yeah. Then you could start on D. Now why D? Because you've already done D before, right? But this is a different kind of D because you're starting on D and then going down to C. Earlier you played D and went up to E, right? So now it's D, C, B, A, B, C, D, E, D. So starting with ring but going down instead of up. So you get another permutation. Then you could start with C, but not going up. You start the cycle going down. So that'll be C, B, A, B, C, B, A, B, C, D, E, D, C, B, A, B, C, D, E, D. Remember that the rhythm pattern has stayed the same throughout this lesson, right? You're doing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 6 got divided into 2. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2. So that pattern continues. Last note will be B, or the last permutation. That'll be, oh sorry, B is here. Ha. B, A, B, C, D, E, D, C. Right? So you'll be stressing on B. So all of this will give you a different harmonic set. You'll be probably choosing different chords than what you would have chosen had you started with the thumb, which is usually a very traditional thing to do on the piano, right? Start with the thumb and move forward. So let's recap this version or this exercise again. Basically, you take one rhythm pattern, wherein in this case, we are dividing beat number 6 and accommodating 2 notes. And after taking that one rhythm pattern, what you will do is you squeeze in 8 notes, but you start with different starting notes. So instead of starting with A all the time, you could start with B, C, D, E, then D on the way down, C on the way down, B on the way down, and finally A. Right, guys? So in this lesson, we've looked at 3 exercises. The first exercise was to just take A, B, C, D, E, D, C, B and just try to understand different time signatures along with the one you already know, which is 4-4. Then we looked at having different rhythmic patterns through the same note combination. So taking a time signature like 7, which we've taken for most of this lesson, you take 7. And then you have different rhythmic permutations by accommodating 8 notes in 7 beats with all the different ways, as each beat can be changed. You could have beat 1 divided by 2, beat 2 divided by 2, beat 3, and so on and so forth, right? And the last version or the last chapter of this lesson, of this whole exercise, would be you'd keep one rhythmic phrase consistent of the 7, which is dun 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 da da dun 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 da da dun dun, and start with different notes. So you could start with A, you could start with B, you could start with C, you could start with D, you could start with E, and then D, and then C, and then B, and then A. Right? So this lesson will hopefully give you control over the odd time signatures while playing a finger exercise. So my argument is you should always do a lot of things when you want to learn something like an odd time signature. So just counting 7 one way, which we traditionally do as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, or maybe 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Counting that is not enough. You need to make music on this. So usually when we play an instrument, we play covers, or we try to play our own stuff, or we just jam with our friends or fellow bandmates. But we tend to forget that there are time signatures other than 4 available, right? You have 7, you have 9, you have 11. Maybe in another lesson, I could talk about some of the other time signatures like 9, 11, 13, right? So if you want to use these time signatures creatively or at the spur of the moment, it's very important to first of all practice them. So I hope this exercise will be something which you could look at to jumpstart your journey into all these odd time signatures, right? Thanks for watching. Thanks for your patience. Hope you guys found the lesson useful. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. Also, leave us a comment if you have any doubts. And more importantly, if you have not subscribed to our channel, please subscribe right now. And if you have subscribed, please share the video with someone else, with your fellow musician friends, and get them to subscribe. That'll be awesome for us. Cheers, and catch you in the next one.